Today we're going to be talking about how future data is stored in the PI system. Future data is typically data associated with a future timestamp. It's things like predictions or forecasts, projections or goals. And PI Server 2015 now natively supports capturing and storing this type of data. For example, here I'm able to compare my production rate forecast with my actual production rate. This bar indicates the current time here, which means that all of these values have future timestamps. Now, how does this future data and the collection and storage of it fit into the existing architecture of our PI system? So in a typical PI system, we have the data source, and our PI interface is going to collect the data from the data source, and it's going to send that to the PI data archive where the data is stored. So how can we send data with future timestamps? Well, there are specific PI interfaces that can send that type of data. There's the PI interface for RDBMS, there's also the PI interface for UFL, and starting with the 2015 release, there's the PI to PI interface. So these interfaces all support sending data with future timestamps. And they're going to be able to send the data to the PI data archive. And there's a few changes that were made on the PI data archive side to allow this. So what are those changes? Well, there's the new PI point attribute, and we're going to be looking at this later in the video. And this PI point attribute is basically just to designate if this is a PI point that's used for a prediction or a forecast, that type of thing. And then there's new special archive files, and these archive files are going to store the data for these PI points. And these changes are great because if you'll think about it, they're not going to impact any of your existing running PI system. They're not going to impact the existing PI points or the existing archives because they're separate. And let's talk a little bit about these archive files. If we think a little bit about before PI Server 2015, we had a focus really on, you know, collecting the real-time process measurements. And this was the type of data from our machines or our sensors, and it generally was coming in chronologically in real time. And the data is very dense. And we have archive files, and these files are going to store this type of data. And these archives were super efficient at storing this type of data. Now, with the PI Data Archive 2015, we introduced the ability to store predictions, forecasts, and targets. Now, how is this data different from that real-time process data? The data can come in at any time. It may not be chronological. It could even be overwritten if a prediction is updated. And the forecast data, that's typically going to be much more sparse than the process data that you're collecting. And as a result, it makes sense to have a different archive strategy because even just the sizing will be different. So we've introduced special separate archive files, and these archive files are optimized for storing this type of data. They are dynamic to store as little or as much data as necessary. And to distinguish them, we call these future archives. And that just means that these are the archive files that we're going to be storing the predictions, forecasts, targets, that future data in. And to distinguish them from the original archive files, we're going to call the original archive files historical archives. So as you can see, the separate archive file strategy is going to allow you the flexibility to have separate backup strategies or separate archive retention policies. And it makes sure that the storage of the data is optimized for the type of data that it is. Now, one of the most common questions on this topic is, what happens to the future data when the timestamps are now in the past? Well, the data continues to be stored in the future archives. We don't transfer it to the historical archives. Now that we understand that there are these different archive files, let's start off with, first of all, where are they stored? Well, there's a separate directory for future archives that gets specified on an install or an upgrade to PI Data Archive 2015. So here, this is when I was upgrading my PyData archive. And by default, it's just going to make this recommendation to have a subfolder where the subfolder name is future. And this is off of my current existing archive file directory. And the separate directory, again, allows you to have that separate backup or retention policies. And this directory can be changed in the future. So now that we know where they're stored, how can we manage these future archives? Well, these future archives, we can take a look at them in PySystem Management Tools. So I'm going to open up PySystem Management Tools on my PyData archive. And starting with PySMT 2015, when I look at the archives using the plugin Operation Archives, you'll see that there's been a new look. And I can take a look at the future archives by clicking on this tab. And the one thing I really want to emphasize is that the management of future archives is pretty much non-existent, because by default, the future archives are automatically created whenever there's data with a future timestamp. And every future archive, you'll notice like this one here, starts off with a size of 1 megabyte. Really small, so it won't eat up disk space, and it's going to grow dynamically, so it'll be just the right size for the forecast data that you're sending. And the future data archive files are bound by a month time range, so you can tell this by the start and end time. So it's one calendar month. And so, for example, if I have a new value that comes in for August 15th, my PyData archive would automatically create a new future archive file for that month for me. Again, this is a super easy process, and it's really designed so the only thing that I have to manage is my disk space. Now, which data gets sent to the future archives versus the historical archives? Well, that's based on the PyPoint attribute. So remember, the PyPoints have a new attribute that specifies whether or not they're going to be used for a forecast or prediction, the future data. And let's take a look at that. So if I go to Points and Point Builder, so as you can see, we now have a new PyPoint attribute, so stored values with a default value being real-time data. So let's take a look at the choice here. As you can see, I can select future data, and I would change this to future data if I was going to create a PyPoint to be used for a forecast or prediction, for example. And this selection for stored values, I just want to make sure to point out that this is something that's a one-time choice on point creation. It can't be changed later after I hit save and create the PyPoint. And that's because this is essentially designating where the data is going to be stored, and it's going to be optimized for whether it's a prediction or a real-time measurement. So as you can see, it's really easy to use the Py system to capture and store your predictions, targets, forecasts. You just designate your Py point for a forecast or a prediction with this single attribute change here. Then you can use the Py interfaces to send the data with the future timestamps, and asset analytics can also be used to write data with future timestamps as well. And this future data gets stored on the PyData archive in those separate future archive files, which are automatically created.